Should follow her heart.
It's taken Brenda years to build a decent life for herself, okay? Sunny could shatter that in a matter of weeks.
So you don't trust Brenda to live her own life and make
her own decisions? No, I don't trust Sunny. I think he's gonna take advantage of her.
Well, you're a married man now with your own family, so it's no longer any of your concern.
You keep asking, Robin. I can be happily married to Carly and still be concerned for Brenda's well-being.
Yes,
one doesn't diminish the other, okay?
Isn't this also about Sunny? Once he's in the picture, your whole cool detachment just disappears.
This has nothing to do with the revenge on Sunny. This is about looking out for Brenda, and that's it.
She's a grown woman. She's made a life for herself. She's doing meaningful work with ASEC. She's dealing with politicians and CEOs of multinational corporations. She hasn't figured out.
And the minute she gets close to Sunny, she becomes a moving target. You can't argue with that.
Well, Brenda's already in trouble because Jason's protecting her. Anyway, the point is, if you interfere, Brenda will see you as an attractive option. And she's chosen you over Sunny in the past. Do you really want her to do that again?
Sheila Edwards is in recovery. Doesn't look like she's gonna need a second surgery as long as we manage her rehab carefully.
I honestly don't know how you do it with everything going on in your personal life.
Honestly, Chief, I'm just glad I have work.
Yeah, well, as long as it doesn't become the distraction that keeps you from fixing what's broken at home.
I wrecked my marriage, I wrecked a colleague's life, all because of decisions I made, but, you know, I don't think Lisa meant to do what she did, but as long as she's getting
Lisa's getting all the attention she needs at Shady Brook. Hopefully one day she'll be able to move on with her life.
Drake Jr., get someone else to be your personal assistant. I don't have the time.
Time for what?
A call from some jewelry store about something that had to be ready today.
It's Robin's necklace. Today's Robin's birthday.
I mean, you left a marriage before for Brenda when she came back to town. Why wouldn't you do that again? You know, marriages fall apart all the time. I'm proof of that.
I'm sorry for what happened with you and Patrick, but Carly and I are solid. And Brenda is a friend, okay? She's a friend I've known for a very long time.
Yeah, and she loves you. She loves the way you support her and you encourage her. What woman wouldn't want that?
Yes, and I can offer support and encouragement without crossing the line.
Do you love Carly?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
I told you that.
So how do you think she's feeling right now? How do you think she would react if you got on your white horse and you went to rescue Brenda?
Rescue? What are you saying? That I'm good for Brenda, but I should stay away, and Sunny's bad for her, and you're trying to put them together? I don't understand
what
you're doing.
You can't see it because you don't like Sunny. But Brenda and Sunny, they have something very real. Something beyond all the heartache, and a lot has changed in their lives. I really think that they have a chance. I just came here to tell you that. Uncle Matt! I'm home.
Surprise!
Happy birthday!
Yay!
What is this? You didn't think we would forget, did you? You guys didn't have to do this.
Come on, of course we did. It's the perfect time to celebrate the fabulous of you. So, Emmett gets most of the credit.
Yeah, I let her pick out all of the colors from the party store.
Oh, this is so great. You guys are so wonderful. Thank you so much for the surprise.
You look so pretty.
Hi. What's this?
Yeah.
Those flowers are from Nicholas.
Oh, and I hope you like what I got you.
You have great taste. You kidding me? I didn't expect anything.
There's a couple there from Robert and Anna, and your mom said she's going to call you later to wish you a happy birthday.
Oh, this is fantastic. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I feel so blessed.
It's a balloon.
Yeah. Oh, lots of balloons.
There's lots of stuff in presents.
Tiffany. Epiphany.
What?
Look, I know you know what happened here.
Everyone knows what happened here, Drake Jr. I considered selling tickets, but then I thought it would be in bad taste.
Look, I need your advice.
I saw Rabbi Melman counseling patients earlier. Will he do?
I bought the necklace for Robin before we got separated. It's for her birthday. I love her, and I want to tell her, but I'm not sure if I'm crossing the line.
Okay, please, don't make me do this.
I could really use a woman's perspective.
Look,
I am in charge of an overworked, understaffed nursing team that is still facing cuts from the budgetary Grim Reaper. I got my head full of other people's problems that are not of their own making.
You know, she used to find me very charming. What about you? You have an opinion?
I think you need to give Robin some room.
I know it could be in bad taste showing up with a gift that was bought at a different time under different context. You know, it was meant to be a present from a caring husband, not a desperate act from a drowning man.
It's just a suggestion.
You know, Robin's kind of convinced that I'm not meant to be married, and it's scaring me that she might be right.
It's amazing once you become a mom how cake takes on a whole new meaning.
You want me to give Emma her bath to make it easier? I would love to.
Oh, thank you, but honestly, bath time is not a chore to me. I love doing it, and I think with everything that's going on, you know, she needs consistency.
Mommy.
Yeah. And we have a lot to talk about tonight. Everything to be grateful for, right? Family and presents and birthday cake.
If you don't like what I got you, you can return it.
Don't you dare. Are you kidding me? And Uncle Mac, I love my spa day. Thank you.
You know, it's been a challenging year, but we got through it together. It's reason enough to celebrate.
Yeah, this is going to be a start of a new year for you. And it's going to be great. I can feel it.
Thank you. Thank you for everything, you guys.
Want some more? I'm gonna get out of here, but I'll check in with you later.
Okay.
Bye, Mac.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye, Maxie.
Bye. Bye.
You know what? Bye-bye. I'm gonna check in with the office too. The mayor's been crying about budget cuts, so I'll see you later.
Bye, Uncle Mac.
Oh,
love you.
Bye. I love you.
Love you very much.
Love you too. Bye bye.
They love you.
Bye.
Can I tell you a secret? Even with all the things that your daddy's done, I'm sad. I wish he was here.
Thanks.
You want some more?
Sheila Edwards is... Her family can see her now.
Mm-hmm.
All due respect, Chief, I think you're wrong.
It wouldn't be the first time.
You know, if I don't acknowledge Robin's birthday, she might think I forgot or that I don't care, but worst, she could think that I'm giving up. I'm not getting any awards for Husband of the Year. Truth is, it did scare me, marriage, family, the whole thing. I didn't know anything about that, except I said I was gonna be better at it than my father was, and I don't wanna be who I was before. I like who I am when I'm married to Robin, when I'm Emma's father. I want that back. A bad time?
No, it's not a bad time. Yeah, Uncle Mac and Maxie, they threw me a little birthday party. It was really more for Emma. She had a good time, you know, as she is with wrapping paper and cake.
Yes, I do. I wish I would have seen her.
Well, I think Maxie took some pictures, so... You can go upstairs. She's sleeping. You can kiss her if you want to.
That's probably better. I let her sleep. I ordered this a few months ago. It came today, kind of perfect timing.
Well, I didn't expect anything.
Yeah, I bet you didn't. I didn't know what to do today. I was thinking about it all day. You know, I don't want to overstep your boundaries. I want to respect you. But I still want to listen to my heart. My heart said I want you to have it, so.
It's that necklace that medicine woman was wearing.
Yeah. I remember being fascinated listening to you both speak, you two strong women of medicine. I ordered it when you got back to the hotel and you went for a swim.
You're such a skeptic. I thought you were tuning us out.
I heard every word.
It's beautiful. Thank you. But I don't think I can wear it for a while.
It's okay. It takes as much time as you need. I just wanted to come and say happy birthday. Tell you that I'm thinking about you.
Thank you.
I'll go.